Hello students, so last class we discussing photosynthesis, so completed. Today we will discussing transport in plants. Transport in plants. See here, transport in plants. Generally, human beings having mainly circulatory system, it is there. All animals having what it is there? Circulatory system, it is there. So that's why it will be transported to all the parts. But the plants having, there is no circulatory system. So how it will be transported? Substances from one part to another part. See here, first we will discussing in flowering plants what it is required. In flowering plants, substances that needed to be transported, or what it is transporting plants. Here mainly water. Next one, it is mineral nutrients. Next one, it is organic nutrients. Plant growth regulators. Plant growth regulators are hormones. So this is all are required for the plant. Here mainly mineral nutrients are required for the plant. Again, mineral nutrients divided into two types. These are essential elements, macro and also micronutrients. What are there? Here mineral nutrients are divided into two types on the basis of requirement of plant. So these are total 17 elements are there. So both these mineral nutrients are, how many are there? 17 elements. One it is macronutrient, another one it is micronutrients. What are there? Here mainly macronutrients are carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. Next one it is nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, calcium, magnesium, sulfur. Magnesium and sulfur. This is all are macronutrient. Generally macronutrients are large amount it is required. More amount is required for plant. How many are there total? Here 9 macronutrients. Micronutrients are less quantity is required. Less amount is required. require, less amount is required for plant. Here mainly you see micronutrients are boron, iron, manganese, copper, chlorine, zinc, nickel. Okay, this is all molybdenum. So this is all are, which one it is? Copper and chlorine, Cl, chlorine, zinc, nickel, molybdenum. So this is all are micronutrients. This is all are micronutrient. Micronutrients are less amount is required for plant. Less amount is required for plant. So next one it is organic nutrients. Organic nutrients. Here mainly organic nutrients are carbohydrates, carbohydrates and proteins. Proteins, here carbohydrates, proteins, fats, okay, and also lipids. Okay, it is also organic nutrients. This is all our organic nutrients. Plant growth regulators. What are their plant growth regulator? They are also growth promoters or growth inhibitors. Growth promoting or growth inhibitors. So auxins, gibberellic acid, cytokinins, okay, ethylene and abscisic acid. So this is all are, what are their plant growth regulators. This is also required for plant, for growth and development. Okay, so this is all are involving all metabolic activities and also helps to the growth, development, reproduction and heredity. Okay, it is all are involving. Next one, it is these elements are not there. The complete life cycle is, the complete life cycle will be stopped. Okay, when we providing all this, then plant grow properly. Plant grow properly, it will give so fruit formation and initial time it is developed fruits and flowers, seeds it is developed. Okay, so if it is anyone is absent, so the life cycle is not completed. Okay, so mainly this essential, seven essential elements is required for plants. Okay, so this is also flowering plants is required on the basis of traveled substances, on the basis of, on the basis of traveled substances, traveled substances, on the basis of traveled substances, transportation is divided into two types. Transportation is divided into two types. Okay, transport is divided into two types. Two types. So here mainly first one it is short distance. Short distance transport, short distance transport. Another one it is long distance transport. Long distance transport. Short distance transport is nothing but what? It will be transported surrounding area in one cell to another cell or within the cell. Okay, one cell to another cell within the cell. That is a short distance transport. Long distance transport is nothing but it will be transported from one place to another place. One area of the plant to another area of the plant. I mean one part of the plant to another part of the plant. So that is called as a long distance transport, long distance or transport. See here, first we will discussing short distance transport. First we will discussing short distance transport. So again, short distance transport, this is the short distance transport. Again they are divided into two types. What are there? So one it is passive transport. Another one it is active transport. So now we will discussing one by one. Okay, what is short distance transport? So in short distance transport, one it is passive transport, another one it is active transport, another one it is active transport. Then we will discussing long distance transport. See here, first we will discussing here you see, first thing is short distance transport. What is short distance transport? The transport occur, okay, within the cell. Okay, here the transport, transportation occur, within cell or cell to other in tissue, then it is known as short distance transport. See here, the transportation occur within the cell, cell to other cell or cell to other in the tissue. One cell to another cell in tissue only. See here, mainly if you take, this is the cell. Within the cell, here many organelles are there. This is the organelles. So within transportation, within the cell it is also transporting. Within the cell it will be transported. Next one it is, so one cell to another cell within the tissue. Tissue means a group of cells is called as a tissue, So within the cell, that is our cell to cell transportation. So we will see, this is called as a short distance transport. Short distance transport occur by the diffusion process. Here mainly, so short distance transport, transport occur by diffusion, process and also cytoplasmic streaming, cytoplasmic streaming means within the cytoplasm it is moving, transportation occur, that is called as a cytoplasmic streaming. Cytoplasmic ट्रेमिंग बाय एक्टिव ट्रांसपोर्ट, एक्टिव ट्रांसपोर्ट, एक्टिव ट्रांसपोर्ट. सी हियर, शॉर्ट डिस्टेंस ट्रांसपोर्ट अकर बाय द डिफ्यूजन एंड साइटोप्लाज्मिक स्ट्रीमिंग एंड साइटोप्लाज्मिक स्ट्रीमिंग बाय एक्टिव ट्रांसपोर्ट. एक्टिव ट्रांसपोर्ट, एक्टिव ट्रांसपोर्ट मीन्स वॉट, इट रिक्वायर एनर्जी टू ट्रांसपोर्ट द मटेरियल्स आर सब्सटेंसेस फ्रम वन प्लेस टू अनदर प्लेस. ओके, सो वन प्लेस टू अनदर प्लेस मीन्स हियर वन सेल टू अनदर सेल इट विल बी ट्रांसपोर्टेड. सो साइटोप्लाज्मिक स्ट्रीमिंग इज नथिंग बट वॉट हियर मेनली विथ इन द साइटोप्लाज्मा वॉट हैपन मेनी ऑर्गनेल्स आर देर हियर टू हियर इट इज मूविंग. ओके, साइटोप्लाज्मा टू मूविंग within the organelle, so at the time it require ATP, here it is require ATP, so that is called as a cytoplasmic streaming. Cytoplasmic streaming means within the cytoplasma it will be transported. Okay, so this is called as a cytoplasmic streaming. So this is nothing but short distance transport. So now we will discussing types of short distance transport. Okay, here see, so another one it is short distance transport, it is not depending on vascular tissue system. Okay, here short distance transport not depending on vascular tissue system. Vascular tissue system. What is there? Vascular tissue system is nothing but what? So xylem and also phloem is there. Xylem and phloem. Okay. So vascular tissue system, it is vascular bundles. Xylem and phloem, it is there. Okay. So short distance transport not depending on vascular tissue system. So next we will discussing short distance transport and its types. Okay, so next one it is short distance transport again divided into two types. What are there? One it is passive transport, another one it is active transport. Okay, passive transport and active transport. First we will discussing passive transport. What is passive transport? The transportation occur according to concentration gradient. Mainly passive transport. Okay, the transportation occur according to concentration gradient. According to concentration gradient. According to concentration gradient. Okay. So what is concentration gradient? Here concentration gradient means, so the transportation of substances it is moving from high concentration to low concentration. It is moving high concentration to low concentration. Low concentration without consumption of ATP. Okay. Without consumption of ATP is called as a passive transport. So passive transport occur according to concentration gradient. So what is concentration gradient? High concentration to low concentration it is moving. So for example, if you take here water, it is there. So the water here high concentration it is there. Here high concentration is there. It is moving from high concentration to here low concentration it is there. So the water content is low. So now where it is moving? High concentration to low concentration it is moving. So that is called as a concentration gradient. Okay, transportation occur according to concentration gradient. Here high concentration it is there, here low concentration it is there. Now water it is moving always high concentration to low concentration it is moving. High concentration to low concentration it is moving. So again passive transport, again they divided into two types. One it is so diffusion, one it is so diffusion. So next one it is facilitative diffusion. Facilitated diffusion. Okay, again they are divided into passive transport, again divided into two types. One it is a diffusion, another one it is a facilitated diffusion. See here, next we will discussing so long distance transport. Long distance transport. Long distance transport. What is long distance transport? The transportation occur, okay, so nothing but the transport over a long distance proceeds through vascular tissue system. Okay, the transport over long distance through or over a long distance proceeds through vascular tissue system. Vascular tissue system is nothing but what? Jhelum and phloem. Through phloem only it will be transported over a long distance. Okay, the transportation so occur here, you should write occur, transportation occur over a long distance proceeds through the vascular tissue system. So here vascular tissue system it is also helps to the long distance transportation. So long distance transportation, so mainly it is depending on bulk flow movement, okay, or mass flow movement. Bulk flow or mass flow movement. Bulk amount of nutrient and water it will be transferred from root region to all the parts. Okay, so that's why it is a bulk flow or mass flow movement. Dissolved nutrients it is transported from root region to leaf region, that is called as a mass flow. Bulk amount of nutrient it will be transporting to all the parts, that is called as a bulk flow movement. Okay, it is mainly, so what is a translocation? It is also known as a translocation. What is a translocation? So transfer of substances, okay, the movement of substances from where to where it is moving, from one place to another place it is moving. Okay, that is called as a translocation. One part of the plant to another part, from root to leaf it will be transported, that is called as a translocation. Translocation means transfer of minerals or water it will be transferred from root region to leaf region through the vascular tissue system. It is called as a translocation. So that is considered as a long distance transportation. Long distance transportation. Okay, so direction of how it will be direction, the mineral nutrition, the transportation direction, how it will be takes place. See, first we will see in jhelum. So jhelum mainly, so it is also transported water plus minerals. Water plus minerals, it is transported only unidirectional. From where to where it is? Root to leaf region. Root to leaf region. This is called as a unidirectional. Unidirectional. Okay, unidirectional transport. Unidirectional transport. If you take a phloem, okay, so phloem, so mainly phloem, it is transporting photosynthetic substances. From where to where it is transporting? From leaf to root is transporting. So again, sometime what will happen, it will be storage food. So due to the unfavorable conditions, okay, what happened? The food will be from root to leaf, it will be transporting. So from leaf to root, root to leaf, so this is called as a bidirectional transport. Okay, so they may be multi directional transport. Okay, it is transporting from all the parts, from root to leaf, again leaf to bud, buds to, so different fruits and flowers. Okay, it is transporting. So this is bidirectional, multi directional transport. Okay, so this is also we are observing. Okay, next one is organic compound. Here photosynthesis means what? Organic compounds is nothing but, so photosynthesis result, what it is producing? Photosynthates. Synthates means the food materials. The food materials, it will be transported from leaf region to root region. Okay, so sometime what happen, it will be storage in a storage organ in unfavorable condition. Okay, in unfavorable condition in earlier springy season, so the leaves will be fall down at the time root is providing to young leaf developing or buds developing. Okay, mainly buds developing, so the nutrients it is providing from root region to leaf region. So that's why only, so phloem, it is a bidirectional transport. From root leaf to leaf region it is synthesizing, that is transported root region, it will be storage in root region. Again when it is unfavorable condition, then it will be, food will be transported to upward direction. So that is bidirectional, upward and downward it is moving. What it is moving? Food materials. So that's why it is called as a bidirectional transport. That's why it is called as a bidirectional transport. So next one, it is we will discussing means of transport. Means of transport. In means of transport, we are discussing one, it is diffusion, another one it is facilitative diffusion, another one it is active transport. Okay, one it is diffusion, second one it is facilitative diffusion, third one it is active transportation. So what is diffusion? We will discussing here. Okay, transport in plants. So next one it is diffusion. Okay, next topic is means of transport. In means of transport, means of transport, in means of transport, first we will discussing, so diffusion, next facilitated diffusion, next one is active transport. So first one it is diffusion. What is diffusion? The movement of molecules, ions or atoms. Okay, the movement of molecules or atoms or ions, atoms or ions of material, of material, okay, of material, it is moving. Okay, the movement of molecules, atoms, ions are, okay, here mainly movement of molecules, atoms, ions of material, it is moving from region of high concentration to region of low concentration. So it is called as a diffusion. okay, it is called as a diffusion. The movement of molecules or atoms, ions of materials from a region of high concentration to region of low concentration, it is moving, that is called as a diffusion. See here, if you take two chambers here, okay, so two chambers here, water molecules are low, it is there. Here water molecules are more, it is there. Here water molecules are more, it is there. So what happened? Water, it is more. So here water is always, it is moving from high concentration to low concentration till equilibrium established. Till equilibrium established. Okay. So diffusion occur. Okay. What happened? The diffusion. So the diffusion continue till equilibrium established. Till equilibrium means net movement is zero. Okay, what happened? In both sides are, so the concentration equal. Okay, in both sides are concentration equal. Up to now what happened? The water molecules having kinetic energy, it is moving from high concentration to low concentration. Now what happened? Equilibrium is constant. Okay, there is no equilibrium. Okay, till equilibrium, so established. Till equilibrium is nothing but what? Both sides are the water molecule equally distributing. So at the time here, net movement is zero. Okay, why? Because so up to where? Here high water potential to low water potential, it is moving till equilibrium continue. So both sides are concentration equal. So net movement is zero. There is no movement. Equilibrium is, so till equilibrium is established, then net movement is zero. Okay, there is no net movement. Okay, so this is called as a diffusion. So next one, it is features of diffusion. So it is also downhill process. Why they called as a downhill process? Because it is moving from high concentration to low concentration. Okay, it is moving from high concentration to low concentration, that is called as a downhill process. It is also passive movement. Okay, passive movement. It is passive transport. It is not require energy. Okay, it is not require energy. It is a slow process. It is a slow process. It is not depending on living system. Living system. Okay, it is not depending on the living system. For example, if you see, you take one spray bottle, just you spray at the one corner of the room, then it will be spreading entire available space. Okay, so that is called as a diffusion. Okay, otherwise if you take a dye, okay, the dye part you put into the glass of water, what happened? The dye, it is dissolved, it is spreaded entire water, then totally the water, it is turned to the that color. Okay, what dye? For example, blue dye we are adding, so entire it is occupying that dye. So finally what we are, it will be distributing equally in all the sides. So now what happened? Net movement is zero. Okay, so that's why it is not depending on a living system. Okay, it is diffusion is mainly it is depending on plants. Okay, diffusion is mainly for plants, for exchanging of gases. What are their gases? CO2 and also oxygen. Okay, this gases exchanging, it is also helps, and it is also helps to the transpiration. This also helps to the transpiration of water. Okay, so the water will be diffusing out through the diffusion process. Okay, so this is the leaf. Okay, the water will be diffusing out through the diffusion process. It is the diffusion process. So this is all our features of features of diffusion. So mainly the diffusion, it is depending on concentration gradient. Okay, factors affecting of diffusion here mainly concentration gradient and also pressure and also temperature. Okay, next one is permeability. So this is all our factors affecting diffusion. Okay, so high concentration, water is more, it is there, then high concentration to low concentration is moving, so pressure will be increasing, the diffusion rate will be increasing. Temperature, when we give temperature, then water will be evaporated. So permeability, so the membrane is permeability, then only more diffusion is take place. If it is not allowing substances, so it is what happened, the membrane is not allowing, diffusion will be reducing. Okay, here mainly, here one more point we are discussing, gases have more diffusion. Then next one, it is liquid. So next one, it is solids. Okay, so mainly we will observing gases and liquids. So more diffusion, gases having more diffusion than the liquid having, so more diffusion solids. Okay, so that is the diffusion rate. More gases are more diffusing, and liquids are comparatively gases less diffusing, and liquids are less diffusing compared, solids are less diffusion comparatively liquids. So some solids, for example ice cube, it will be melting, and it what happened, it will be so moving, okay, evaporating water. So that is also we are observing in solids. Okay, mainly gases, then liquid and solids. So this is nothing but means of transport. Okay, so this is the transport in plant. Tomorrow we will discussing facilitated diffusion. Okay, ma'am. Okay, bye.